Hello, hello, everyone. It's Kelly back at you with some INTR 101 lecture. That sounded a lot like a podcast, and I'm sorry for it. I'm very bored at home. So let's jump into today's lecture. So we're going to be talking about time management, and I grace you all with this terrible meme that I made that's super outdated because I'm old, but that's okay. When I was younger, and by younger, I mean 20, I always kept track of things by writing them on sticky notes and hoping that I remembered where they were and what my weird shorthand meant. And it worked most of the time, but occasionally I forgot some pretty big things. So what I'm trying to get at is writing things on sticky notes for yourself is totally a valid form of time management. But the real question is it a good form of time management for you? And for me, given that I was a mess of a human, it was not, because I lost a lot of those little papers and things. So what we're going to do today is go through how to build a time management plan, structure, calendar, whatever it is for you that works best. So what we're going to do is we're going to identify our priorities. We're going to make sure that our schedule is visible. We're going to create an action plan. We're going to get organized, and we're going to breathe, right? So these are all of the major things that go into good time management. So when we're identifying priorities, we want to think about what goes into our schedule, right? What are we doing weekly, daily, monthly? So some key things that we can include are classes, study time, meals, work, sleep, and breaks. Now, usually when I do this in class, I ask people to tell me some of the priorities that should go in their schedule, and a ton of people forget meals and sleep and breaks. So those are all really key, critical things that I want you to think about as we're going through this presentation and as you're building a schedule for yourself. So when we're actually building that schedule, we want to start with things that have set times that you can't change. Right, so classes and work, those are good examples. Then we want to add in some study times, and I highly recommend to keep these between 1 and 1.5 hours. And then we want to make sure that we don't forget meals, breaks, and other activities. So when we're building a schedule, just as important as class are breaks. And the reason for this is that you need some time to let your brain chill a little bit in between big things. So you'll notice in these schedules that I build in some short break times. And this helps with a couple of things. One, it reminds you to take a second to pause, to breathe, to give yourself some space. And two, it can help fight that guilt. So a lot of times when people are studying and they know that they need to take a break, they still feel guilty about taking it. And sometimes writing it in and scheduling that break for yourself can help alleviate that guilt. It also helps you keep track of it, right? So that your break doesn't turn from 30 minutes to a year and a half, right? So we want to make sure that when we're scheduling in those breaks, we're being mindful about it and mindful about our needs. So here is a sample weekly schedule, and we're going to kind of build it as we go. So first things first, we're going to put in our class times. So this was just kind of a typical schedule that we put together using some four-year plans for a freshman, I believe. So they've got a pretty set schedule for classes, right? Then we're going to add in work. So this person, this happens to be their work schedule for this week, right? And obviously your work schedule might change from week to week, but putting that in first is really good. Now we're going to add in some homework and study times, and notice that these blocks are just an hour long, and it seems like a lot, right? I know when I first threw this in, it was kind of overwhelming to think about just how many blocks of homework and studying are in this schedule. But one thing to think about is if you've ever done some time tracking where you sit down and you journal out what you're doing each hour of the day, you'll notice that you might actually spend this much time doing homework and studying. One nice thing is, let's say you blocked out all this time and you get to Thursday night and you realize, wow, I'm done with everything. Cool, now that can be free time, right? So you can be a little bit flexible with that time if you get done with stuff early. So don't forget sleep. I know it seems strange to set a bedtime for yourself, but you won't regret it in the long term. One professor gave me some really good advice, which is whatever you do, don't horrendously screw up your sleep schedule while you're in college, because sometimes it's really hard to fix it. So making sure that you get to bed on time and are waking up at a consistent time can really help add some normalcy to your life. So I'm adding in meals, right? So I'm not going to tell you how to eat, what you should eat, what time you should eat, but you definitely need to eat. So find some time in your schedule that you want to have for your meals, right? And notice that this person's dinners are very different from day to day, but they still blocked that time out for themselves. They were able to keep lunches really consistent most days, and that just is kind of luck in there, but make sure that you're getting some food. And then finally, breaks are really important, so make sure to include them, right? If there's one thing that you can take away for this, it's that scheduling breaks is a really good thing to do for yourself. And this person just put them in between everything else. Sometimes they were just titled break, which is kind of free for all, right, on what you want to do. And other times they gave them specific tasks, right? So there's some travel time. There's a friend night on Saturday, which is really lovely. You know, if you have some consistent breaks that you want to put in your schedule, that can be something to really look forward to through the week. So maybe you're having a really rough Friday, but you could think about like, oh, hey, tomorrow I get to hang out with my friends. So including those things is really important. Now, planning for every single hour of the day can be a bit overwhelming. So I know I'm going to go back to that schedule really quick. Personally, when I look at this, it's far too much. Having every single hour of my day blocked out is really overwhelming for me. So this is a sample schedule that I made that's a little bit less, right? So it doesn't have as much time blocked out for every single hour of the day. And the point is, when it comes to scheduling, you want to make sure that that scheduling is meeting your needs. So I still put in all my classes and when I had work, and I was going off of sort of the schedule that I had when I was an undergraduate, and I actually had a really consistent work schedule because I worked as a tutor. So that was really fortunate, and that was able to be consistent week to week. Now you'll notice that I still put in some times to study, and this is something that I do highly encourage you to try out. So even if you aren't like this schedule where you're putting in tons and tons of blocks, just putting in a couple blocks here and there can really help you stay on top of your studying, right? So if we look at this schedule in this week, I definitely studied more than I put down, right? So when I took game theory, that was a class that involved a lot of time. And when I took this FLEN 301 class, it involved a lot of work. So obviously I was doing more studying than what is shown here, but putting those blocks in for myself gave me some place to start. And we'll talk about a little bit more in our studying lecture. But take a sec and compare these two different schedules. You can go back and forth on the slides that I have posted. And what one feels more comfortable to you? And you might say, like, even this schedule here has too much detail and I want just a little bit less. I only want to put in two study blocks. That's cool. It's whatever you need for yourself. But I do encourage you to push yourself just a little and include, you know, one more study block than you think you would normally do, just to kind of form this habit of good study habits. Okay, so this is all well and good, but these schedules really focus on having classes in person, which right now we don't. So let's talk about how we build a schedule when you're completely online. So one benefit is that online courses can provide a lot of freedom. Let's say you're working remotely, you're living remotely, it can be really useful to have those online classes. Or if you have a really bizarre work schedule, it can be really helpful for that. But that freedom can also be really difficult when you are used to a lot of structure. So building these schedules is a way for yourself to give yourself some structure. And this can help with motivation and keeping you on top of the actual work that you need to get done. So one tip for this is to remember to be specific. Say exactly what you plan on doing during the time that you block out. So in our previous schedules, we would just say like homework and study. When you're working online mostly, it can be better to be a bit more specific. So I'll give you an example here. So right now, some of you might have classes that require you attending a Zoom lecture. So just like our previous schedule, we're going to plug those in first because there might be a time requirement on them. So that's what I'm assuming here. Now, if it's like INTR, you might have some classes where they recorded lectures, posted notes or slides, anything like that that you can do throughout the week. It's still important to schedule time for yourself to go in and do those things. So a lot of times I hear students who take online classes during a normal semester just being like, yeah, I kind of put it off until Saturday night and then have to speed to get it all done, which can be a lot of stress for yourself. So blocking out some time during the week to like dedicate to that specific course is really useful. And kind of treat it like it's another class. So I did hour and a half chunks twice a week for each class that I would have at that time. Then you want to plug in homework and studying just like you did before. So you can be really specific with these. You could say, I'm going to do the Zoom lecture for bio and then do homework for bio after each of those. And having that amount of structure can be really good for yourself again, just like we've talked about. So when it comes to online courses, you might need a little bit more time to do that homework and to do some of that really in-depth studying. So make sure to account for that. So I left a lot of space in this schedule, and part of that is that I didn't account for a work schedule. But the other side of it is that I wanted to account for a lot of flexibility. And that's something that's really important to give yourself when you have a lot of online classes. So realizing that things might take longer than expected, right? That recorded lecture might be a 25-minute lecture when last week it was only a 15-minute lecture. So giving yourself some time in between things to kind of shift your schedule around is something valuable. Now, that's not always possible, right? If you have a really intense work schedule, it might be hard to build in some of that flexibility. So just touching base with your instructor, you know, reaching out to them and letting them know that given current circumstances, there are a lot of things out of your control is something really valuable to do. So let's talk about actually making the schedule visible, right? So you find the method that works for you. And it's important to make sure that your schedule is visible. Actually recording what you need to do can help motivate you to do it. So you can use a paper planner if that works really well. But you also have your phone and tons and tons and tons of organizational apps. So, you know, use that technology that you have. I use my Outlook calendar all the time. It's my go-to. But I also plug everything into my phone just because I know that I always have those things with me and I'll lose scraps of paper. So figure out what method is best for you. So once you have that method, we want to talk about scale, right? So there's semester, monthly, weekly, daily, hourly, you know, the five-year plan. There are all different scales for scheduling. So let's go through sort of what those scales are and what's useful and not useful about them. So looking at a semester schedule, this is great for finding trends in your semester. So attached here is this like semester schedule that we made for, I think, a first year anthropology student. And with a semester schedule, it's really good to plug in big things, right? Big deadlines, projects, papers, reoccurring homeworks. And what you can do is identify when you have a really busy week. So maybe there's a week where you have three tests due, right? You want to be able to plan ahead so that you can get some studying done the week before and not cram during that week. Unfortunately, with a semester schedule, you don't have a lot of detail about what is happening each week or day, so you don't get a chance to really schedule minutely. So that brings us to a weekly schedule. So those are what I showed beforehand, and they have definitely a lot more detail than a semester schedule. So it's easier to see where you have free time within your day. But as I mentioned, they can be a little overwhelming, right? It can be hard to see that much information at once. And furthermore, you can't easily see what's coming up next week. So maybe you make your semester or your weekly schedule for this week and you have a ton of free time, but you don't realize that next week you have two exams and more hours at work and it's just a lot busier. So having a mix of both a semester and a weekly schedule can be a really good way to kind of find that middle ground of enough detail for yourself. So then we're going to take it down to a daily schedule. So a daily schedule can be as simple as a to-do list, right? The one that I have here is really fancy, broken down hour by hour. But this is where those small slips of paper just for the day to make a list on can be really great. And it's a good way to give your day some structure to kind of figure out what exactly you need to get accomplished. But it can get overwhelming if you schedule too many things in one day. So I give myself the rule of no more than 5 big items a day. So little things like respond to that email or, you know, shoot someone a text, anything like that, those are fine to add in a bunch. But if I have something big like finishing a presentation or working on a rough draft of a paper, I try and keep that to 5 or fewer. And this just helps me not get so overwhelmed. One way that I kind of divvy up my work is I make a giant master to-do list at the beginning of the week, and then I break it down to about 5 items per day throughout. And before you know it, the whole list is done. So we can talk about the Pomodoro technique, which is time management for the small scale. So it's a way to organize how you work. You want to understand the task and break it into chunks, which are called Pomodoros. So the way that it works is for each 25 minutes of intense focus, you give yourself a 5-minute break. So after 4 of those back and forths, you give yourself a 30-minute break. And what's really great about the Pomodoro technique is that it gives you a goal to get through maybe an hour and a half of studying, right? When you sit down to study for that big block of time, it can seem really overwhelming, but trying to get yourself to just study for 25 minutes is a lot easier to do. So we'll talk about the Pomodoro technique a little bit more in the studying lecture and how to do it there. But I like to think of it as time management hour by hour. So one other way to give yourself some structure and make a plan is to create an action plan. So an action plan is a way of taking a large task and breaking it up into smaller, more manageable pieces. You can action plan big projects, homework, assignments, study sessions, pretty much anything. I have action planned a vacation. I've action planned aspects of my relationship. Listen, you can do it all with an action plan. So when making your action plan, it's really important to include intermediate deadlines. And these deadlines help prevent procrastination. So if we reflect back on our Idaho goal, we had that step, actualize the steps. And what you were doing was making a sort of action plan. So you can action plan your study plan. And this is actually one of the assignments that I'm going to have you do this week, is to develop a study plan for your class or for a class that you have right now. So here's an example, you know, find 2 text sources, skim the first and last chapters, take notes. So usually with action plans, it's good to include some campus resources that you can use to help, and then identify some of the roadblocks that you might run into while trying to accomplish it. So we'll talk about action planning and a study plan in the next lecture as well, but this is something that I want you to try out. So we've kind of planned out our semester, our week, our day, our hour. We've given ourselves an action plan. Now we want to get organized to actually accomplish some of the stuff. So creating a workspace that is both physically and digitally efficient is really useful, right? You want to establish an organization system that's clear and consistent, and you want to arrange files and papers in a way that makes sense. So now that we're online, I'm sure that you're submitting a lot more homework, you know, on Blackboard Learn, a lot more stuff digitally. So it's important to have a really good folder system for yourself. And this might seem like a little thing that like isn't that really, really important, but it can be. So think if you're in English 101, right? You're going to make your master folder for English 101. And in there, you're going to divide the folder up into some of the major things that you do in there. And then for each of those folders, you'll divide it up a little bit further so that you have really clear and consistent names for all of the files. And you're not just doing like a key smash or that one thing or essay correct, correct, final, really, really correct. You're giving yourself a little bit more structure. So taking time to actually organize files well can help you find things more quickly in the future. It was something that I had to do when I got to grad school, is I had to like take a sec and figure out how I was going to file everything so that it was more useful for myself. And notice on this file name, this like Christensen_SA1, what's nice is when you turn that into an instructor, that looks professional, right? Christensen_SA1 looks a lot better than like silly English essay, final version 2, which I have turned in files like that, and it's not the greatest. So definitely try and give yourself a clear file naming system as well. So how can we handle interruptions? And this is really pertinent right now where, you know, we have this sudden change to online. And I've talked with a lot of students, and one of the biggest struggles is finding some structure and dealing with all of these changes. So there's some things to keep in mind. Priorities change, right? So maybe a class that was super important beforehand is now put on the back burner and something a bit more challenging has come to the forefront, right? And life happens. So maybe you had to quickly move off campus, you had to get all of your stuff, you're at home where maybe the internet isn't as good, or it's a really stressful family dynamic, right? All of this stuff can get in the way. Keep in mind that a good plan can always be improved. So maybe you were feeling really good about this online transition. Notice that there are small ways that you can probably improve the experience for yourself to really mitigate any further stress. Things don't always go according to plan. This semester is a great example of this. So we have to remember to be flexible with our schedules because stuff like this might happen, right? You might have extra time than you thought about. If we think about that weekly schedule we built, you know, maybe you finish all your assignments really early in the week. Well, what do you do with that extra time? Do you use it to work ahead? Do you use it to take a little bit of a break? How best can you use that time for yourself? And you might also have less time. You know, maybe an assignment that you blocked out 2 hours for ends up taking 4 and runs into the time that you set aside for another assignment, and things start to pile up. You know, how do we take a second to work through that, to breathe, to figure out a new plan of attack? And then keep in mind that other people might need your help, right? So this is really important right now. You might have family or friends that need you to run groceries for them, or, you know, do little tasks around the house. And how do we plan around those things? So my suggestion is to breathe first, because usually it can be overwhelming and there can be sort of a stress response. So breathe and then start making a list, right? If your priorities change, how do they change? How can we sort of reorder things that are going on? Return to that weekly schedule and look at what stuff can be moved around a little bit in order to accommodate having less time to do certain projects. And if you have extra time, looking ahead, saying, oh, well, next week I have a rough draft of my paper due. I should start working on it now and get it out of the way, right? So using this time efficiently and constantly adapting your schedule so that it's useful and allowing you to accomplish all that you want is really important. So my biggest takeaway here is time management is stressful. It really is. Trying to find a schedule and making sure everything goes right is really difficult. So when things start to feel overwhelming, especially now, give yourself 30 seconds to breathe and then start looking at the facts that you have, building that schedule around the things that you know for sure are going to happen, and then kind of finding places in there to put in everything else. So that's the content of the lecture. What I want to do right now is look at BB Learn for a second. So I'm going to jump over to my web page. So right now you should notice that there is a new folder available in the weekly presentations and resources tab, and that's week two. So it has the lectures up for both time management and studying. And there should also be a new lecture shortly given to us by Vandal Health Ed. So they put together some really nice stuff to help you kind of cope with how changing things are right now. So that'll be put in here along with the recordings as they get finished up and posted. I will post announcements for each one of those. And then in the attendance and participation assignments folder, I've sort of done some refiling. So I put all of those week one assignments into a week one assignment folder. And now we're on to week two. So if you check that out, there are two little deliverable things to do this week, as just like last week. So one is to make a weekly schedule, and one is to action plan for studying or for a project. So we're going to check out the weekly schedule one. And what I want you to do is to make a weekly schedule for yourself for this week, for next week, a week that you have coming up. And then you can use the attached template that I provided. It's an Excel spreadsheet. Or you can find any other weekly schedule template that you like. If there's something that you've made yourself, awesome, use that. If you have everything plugged into your Outlook calendar or your Google calendar or Apple calendar, take a screenshot and you can put that in there. And then upload an image or a PDF of that schedule. You can check out, again, this lecture for examples. And then I also posted those examples in this little folder. So you can check out, I put three of them there. If you have any questions, let me know. For the action plan one, I'll go over it a little bit more in depth in the studying lecture, because that's what it sort of pertains to. But you can check out that assignment, and there is an example of what I want you to do right below it. So with that, the other thing to keep in mind is just keep an eye on your grades. I've put in all of the participation grades as of Monday the 30th at 9:15 p.m. I'll be putting in the reflection grades probably Tuesday and Wednesday, so those should all be done soon. If you have any questions about those grades or about feedback, please let me know. I'm always happy to clarify things, go over the work, everything like that. So with that, I hope you all have a lovely day. It's been a week, but we're going to make it through, and stay safe out there. Bye, team.